questions. And these questions are posed, some of them are by real aspirants and some of them who are having idle curiosity. So master
answers every question according to the stage of evolution of the one who poses the question. So this is one of such books which presents the answers to the questions. This is in this book you have various aspects on which master has given answers. One chapter is about Vedas, another chapter is about religion, another chapter about God, fourth chapter about yoga, fifth on man and dharma, sixth law of karma, and seventh is on astrology, eighth is about the guru, and nine is about spiritualism, and 10 is miscellaneous aspects. So I will only present only two or three questions which were posed and how master answers them. So the first question in this book is about Vedas. One person questioned him, old people claim that Vedas are not written by man but by God. What is your view? This was the question. And you see master how he gives the answer straight on. He says that learned people of all nations claim the same thing about their own scriptures. So the person has put this question only about Vedas, because the Vedas are said to be apaurusheya, that means not written by man. So this is always a puzzle among the minds of these many persons. If something is not written by man, how it came into existence? That is the question. But often such question is put about Vedas, but not other scriptures. But in fact, every scripture is coming from God only. It is not written by man. That is what master, first of all, he starts his answer drawing our attention to the fact that every scripture of any religion, because in fact, any scripture does not belong to any religion. That is the first thing. The religions try to possess the scriptures as if the scripture is their own. But in fact, no scripture can be possessed by any religion, because religions are framed by human beings, not by God. So therefore, he says that the same, all the learned people of any nation, they claim the same thing about their own scriptures or gospels, and this is by no means untrue. So the word Veda means, he explains the word Veda, because unfortunately the Vedas are wrongly understood as the scriptures belonging to one religion which is called Hinduism. So it is not true. If they are claimed to be the scriptures of Hinduism, either by Hindu or a non-Hindu, both are at fault. Wrong understanding. Veda is not a book, it is a wisdom, which is definitely a book but an impersonal concept, because the essence of any scripture is about the impersonal phenomena of his creation. So therefore, nobody can claim as the author of these books. So he says that this is received as an experience by those whom we call the Vedic seers, and it is recollected on the buddhic plane. So this is the experience which they have received on the higher plane about his creation. It is again recollected on the buddhic plane. And as it is further recollected in the buddhic plane, and the mental plane where from it is translated into the known language of the century and spelled out. So when you have certain insight, certain experience, so that experience is bestowed upon you by the higher forces of nature, and when this experience is recollected and this recollection is translated into the known language, does it mean that he is the author of this? So he cannot claim himself to be the author of this experience, because it is experienced again and again by many who are ready for this, to receive this experience. So that is what Master says. Further, these seers are not afraid of attest. So here, this is the wonderful thing what he has given the answer. Since it is not characterized by the individual, it is bound to be impersonal. So all the such experiences which are recorded, they are not tainted by the individual character of the person who has recorded this. So they are impersonal. And he has given a wonderful example to establish this. He says that there is the multiplication table. When somebody is learning mathematics from the very childhood, every student of mathematics is expected to practice, to study the multiplication table. And you know, when somebody claims that he has written a new multiplication table, it is absurd. Anytime any person, if he wants to write a multiplication table, he has to write in the same manner as before. If he wants to change and wants to make his own multiplication table, then he proves himself to be a fool. So it is absurd. So the multiplication table, when it is written in the 20th century, once again 21st century, or afterwards 22nd century, it must be the same. You can't change it. Therefore, it is impersonal. It is eternal. In this sense, it is claimed as the work of God. Further, these seers are not afraid of attesting their names as in the passages of the Vedic, as of the Vedic hymns composed by them. So it is a composition of the hymns, the mantras. So they are the composers. That means they have recorded the experience and composed them in the poetic form, but still they are not claimed to be the authors of this. So it is impersonal. At the same time, they do not claim to be the authors of these mantras, and they class themselves only as the seers of the import. So such is the answer, straight and very clear explanation what always Master gives to all the answers that are for the questions that are posed to him. And there are so many questions like this in different chapters, as I told you. I'll pick up only another one question, and then because I have to also leave at least a few minutes to our Punaya also. Spiritualism. In what way spiritualism is different from religion? That is another question. Because always the spiritualism is confused with religion. There are two different things. You can be a spiritualist, but you need not be a religious person. But unfortunately, these two are always considered as the same. So what Master says for this is, it is the same as difference, the difference between education and educational institution. So he has given an example to explain this. Education and educational institution. So the religion is like an educational institution, and spiritualism is like education. So if somebody thinks that education and educational institution are the same, then he has no proper understanding. As we see thousands of educational institutions in this world, like schools, colleges, universities and libraries, so too we find various religions. You have so many religions in this world, but they are like educational institutions. We have innumerable institutions for education in every country. Like this, we have innumerable religions also. Each institution has its own way of imparting the required education, and more particularly imparting the discipline required to a student who undergoes training to learn and digest the required branch of wisdom. The course to be studied in a medical college is always the same, having the same ends and objects. So, wherever you go, if you want to learn medicine, wherever you enter into any medical institution, then that particular education is the same. If you want to study engineering and you enter into an engineering institution anyway, so basically it is the same. So, we find the various medical colleges having their own way of imparting the medical knowledge. So, the method of imparting may be different, but the subject is the same. So, spiritualism is an impersonal science discovered by the human being for his own uplift and enlightenment of his own awareness. It is the light kindled by man as his own awareness, which is followed by himself as his own goal. So, Master has clarified the difference between spiritualism and religion. So first of all we should understand what is religion and what is spirit, because spiritualism is something which is linked to your way of living. So for this, religion is only a training school and it has its own limitation. Every religion has its own limitation, like how every education institution has its own limitations, but education has no limitation. So also, spiritualism is not limited at all. So, the Lord comes down to earth to emit the light of subjectivity into the world of objectivity. In trying to gather or to recollect that light, people discover a new religion. That is how all the religions have come into existence.
People discover
religions. It is not Lord. The God never discovers or never inaugurates any religion. That is what always Master used to explain. That, for example, Lord Krishna has never established a religion like Hinduism, or neither Christ has established a religion like Christianity. So, Lord has no means to establish any religion to propagate his own teachings. He comes down to earth again and again and gives out his teachings to humanity. But for that purpose, there is no need of. He doesn't depend upon any religion. He is above all religions. But religion is necessary to impart certain discipline for a person. So that is true. But spirituality is above religion. That is what Master has explained for this question. So, like this, this is only for your interest that I have just mentioned. About two questions. There are so many questions that are answered by Master like this, and when once you read these answers, you will be very clear in your mind about these aspects. I have recently translated this into our language also. Our heritage and 20 Anglamlo Master Gari chinatundi danni Mana Samskruti ane 20 perato Mana Swetadvipanlo అది కంటిన్యూస్గా వేసుకోవడం జరిగింది. ఈ ప్రశ్నలకు సమాధానం అనేటువంటి మాస్టర్ గారు ఇచ్చింది. ఇప్పుడు ఇంకా మన పుణ్యశాస్త్రి గారు ఎలాగో సాయంత్రం మాట్లాడతారు కాబట్టి ఈ పిల్లలకి ఎక్కువ సమయం ఇచ్చాం. నేను కొద్దిగా, ఆయన మరీ కొద్దిగా. ఆయన కేవలం ఒక రెండు పద్యాలు రాసలీలలోవి రెండు పద్యాలు చదువుతారు. ఆ వెంటనే చిరంజీవి అనంతాచార్య యొక్క ప్రసంగం ప్రారంభం అవుతుంది. వాసుదేవ అయ్యా,
కృష్ణుని చూసి దేవకీ దేవి పొందినటువంటి అనుభూతి. పాదసంద్రముపైని వాలారు కెరటాల కలు చిలువడోలికలు చిట్టి వెల్పు క్షీరడిండీరం పుచిరు తుప్పరలు మేన మెరుగుగూర్చిన వింత పురిటి బిడ్డ కనులున్న భాగ్యంబు కలిగించి లోకాలనరింతు కనుదోయి వెలుగు పాప బంగారు తల్లియౌ పద్మను వక్షాన నిలిపి కుల్కించెడి చెలిమికాడు కాలవ అర్ధిగూడమున లోకమ్ముల నడిపిచుకగూళ్లను నిర్మించి వింతలొలుగు చిన్ని ఆటలాడడి కొత్త శిశువు నేడు పేర్మి మా గర్భమున గూటి పితుక జయ్యే. ఇంకొక పక్క చెప్తాను. శ్రీకృష్ణుడు మట్టి తిన్నాడని బలరాముడు ఆరోపించినప్పుడు యశోదాదేవి అతన్ని నోరు తెరవమని మృద్భక్షణ ఘట్టం అంటారు దాన్ని. ఆ ఘాట్ కూడా చూశాను మేము సార్ మొట్టమొదట ఎట్లా కనపడింది ఏమంట.
అది యొక్క గోడమై పృథులమై వదనాంతర గహ్వరంబునందు ఉదిత పరిభ్రమద్గతుల నొప్పుతూ లోపలి అంధకారమందు ఉదితులు సూర్యచంద్రులు మహోడు పదంబులు వచ్చిపోవుతున్ విదిత మహాసముద్రములు విత్తుతూ మూయుతు దోచ చూడగన్ ఉర్వీధరంబులు ఉర్వీచరంబులు జలరాజి పొంగులు జలచరములు అంబరంబులు పక్షుల భ్రములు మెరబులు దంభోడి ఐరావతము శుక్రుడు ఇంద్రుడు ఓషధి వర్గమిరుడు చైతన్యంబు సృష్టికర్తల గుంపు సృష్టికర్తలు అప్సరోవర్గంబులు ఆఘవంబులు జల ప్రళయములు సుఖశాంతి భద్రతలును.
కింద కూర్చుంటారు తీసేయాలి.